Mine weighs about 22 ounces. He is a little bit underweight because he was hatched in April of this year. This is also why some of his plumage is not fully in. He's got a little bit of buff still in him. He will, in a couple months, he'll have his full color in it. The call duck was originally known as the coy duck or the decoy duck. This came from the Dutch word decoy, which means trap. They were used to catch wildfowl to take to the market. The call duck, the coy duck, was tamed and fed at the entrance to large gates constructed in the form of a pipe. Wildfowl were then enticed down the trap by the quacking of the tamed coy duck. In German, they were known by the word fur, which means fur. This is because the call duck has a very small body. By the 1850s, they were in Britain. They were described as having a head more round than the wild duck. They were compared to a tumbler. The call duck was renamed the coy duck was renamed the call duck in the 1870s. They are seasonal layers laying around from around January to June or July. They lay around 30 to 75 eggs a year. They are known for having lots of personality and being easily tamed. The females tend to be quite noisy. This is why I'm not showing them. They are considered to be hard to breed and hatch. The call duck is compared to the mallard in external appearance and plumage, but they are relatively smaller in weight. The original color of the call duck was white was gray, with white being one of its sports. The standard colors of the call duck now are gray, white, blue, buff, black, pastel, chocolate, butterscotch, and snowy. They are bred mainly for ornamental purposes. They were admitted to standard in 1996. The bill of migrate is short and wide with a concave top line. It is an apple green with a dark beak. Disqualifications of the bill would be a scoop or deformed bill. Migrate has neither. The eyes are large and bright. They are brown. They are set low rather than high in the head. Disqualification of the eyes would be blindness in both eyes or irregular shaped pupils, which indicates leucosis. Defects in the eyes would be blindness in one eye or eyes not matching in color. Migrate has proper eyes. The head is short and round. It is soft powder blue. The cheeks are prominent. The neck is short and arched. It is a soft powder blue cut short by a distinct white collar that fails to quite encircle the entire neck. The back is short and convex. The forward part of it is a brownish mauve becoming blue, and is blue overlaced with slate blue, darker slate blue over the rump. The sex feathers, which my bird has not grown in yet, they're starting to come in, are blue and they will be well curved. The scapulars are blue with gold outer edges. The tail is slightly elevated. A disqualification in the tail would be a twisted or reversed mane tail feather. The tail is a light blue with gold outer edges. The wings are closely folded and held tight to the body. The lesser and middle coverts are brownish blue. The greater coverts are blue with a white bar followed by a slate tip. The primaries are a bluish buff. The buff becomes lighter on the outer edges. The secondaries are a light blue. The outer edges carry a slate bar, which borders each end of the spectrum. The tertials are a brownish blue, with the outer edges being mauve, shading into chestnut on the lower webs. The oxalures are light gray to white. This is the left wing of my jury, and this is the right wing of my jury. Disqualifications in the wings would be angel wings. This is where the tip of the wing is inverted at the outer joint. Defect in the wings would be primaries and secondaries that are broken but not removed. Mine has none of these disqualifications or defects. The breast is small, short, round, and plump. It is a brownish purple bib fading into a slate rose or lilac sheen. It blends well into the abdomen color. The body is short and plump and very small. The smaller the call duck the better without losing any weight. Disqualifications in the body would be a tumor affecting the health or market value of the Derby. The lower thighs are short and plump. They are a blue overlaid with a brown or buff. The shanks and toes should be a salmon color. Mine are not yet salmon colored because it's still underdeveloped. The shanks are short and straight when viewed from front. There are four toes on each foot. The front three toes are connected by a web. This is the hind toe. Disqualifications in the shanks and toes would be bowed legs or deformed feet or foot joints. Defects in the shanks and toes would be missing toenails, missing toes, or missing parts of toes. The plumage throughout my bird in general is blue overlaid with buff and gold. This produces the pastel, lilac, or mauve sheen that you see. This is the right view of the bird. This is the front view of the bird. This is the back view of the bird. Do you have any questions?
How long does it take to hatch a duck? You talked about being ready, but if you had a chair in the way.
Do you have any questions?